ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the graduates of the Faculties of Arts, Commerce and Management, Education, Engineering and Information Technology, Environmental Sciences, Health Sciences, International Business and Politics, Law, Nursing and Health, and the Graduate School of Management. In a few minutes, the graduation ceremony will commence. The procession of start and dais parties will enter. I will signal to you when you are to rise and remain standing until the staff and dais party processions are seated. Please do not stand until I ask you to do so. May I also remind you that flash photography is prohibited within the auditorium, and could I request that you turn off all mobile phones and pagers? Ladies and gentlemen, the Chancellor, Ms. Lynette Ford, will now address us.
His Excellency, Major General Peter Arneson, AO, Governor of Queensland, and Mrs. Arneson. Mr. James Strong, Chief Executive and Managing Director of Qantas Airways Limited. Professor Roy Webb, the Vice Chancellor, distinguished guests, graduands, ladies and gentlemen. It is customary for the university and its guests to gather as a body for the purpose of conferring academic awards on its graduates. On behalf of the Council of the University, I extend a very warm welcome to everyone present for this graduation ceremony. I extend a special welcome to His Excellency, Major General Peter Arneson, AO, Governor of Queensland, and Mrs. Arneson. We're honored by your presence. I also extend a special welcome to Mr. James Strong, Chief Executive and Managing Director of Qantas Airways Limited. Mr. Strong will receive the honorary degree, Doctor of the University, later this afternoon, and we look forward to his occasional address later in the proceedings. This occasion holds special significance for our graduates. Today, in the presence of family, friends, and the entire university community, your dedication and hard work are recognized and rewarded. It holds special significance for me also. As a Gold Coaster myself, it is the first graduation ceremony at which I'm officiating as Chancellor of Griffith University at the Gold Coast. On this occasion, it is also appropriate for me to say a few words about the legacy of Sir Theodore Bray, who passed away recently. Sir Theodore was elected as the first Chancellor of Griffith University in 1975. He was a very active Chancellor and attended every meeting of the University from 1970 until 1985. He was passionate about the establishment of the schools of modern Asian studies and environmental studies at a time when there were no such schools at other Australian universities. After his retirement in 1985, Sir Theodore continued to contribute to the life of the university and to work in its interests. The state of Queensland and Griffith University benefited immensely from his visionary leadership and his role in setting the foundations of a university which now has an established international reputation. I'm honored to have been offered the chancellorship of Griffith. It will certainly be a challenge to follow in the footsteps of Sir Theodore and his distinguished successors, who include my immediate predecessor, the Honorable John McCrossan, AC, who is also here this afternoon, as chancellor of this progressive university, renowned for its innovative and interdisciplinary approach to higher education. The breadth and diversity of its teaching and research covers the spectrum of human endeavor and is manifest in our graduating students. They represent the faculties of commerce and management, law, environmental sciences, arts, engineering and information technology, international business and politics, education, graduate school of management, health sciences, and nursing and health. I'm confident that they will make valuable contributions in these important fields. Griffith is one of the largest multi-campus universities in Australia. It is formed by an integrated network of campuses stretching from Southport here on the Gold Coast to Southbank on the Brisbane River. From these campuses, Griffith serves the higher education needs of its students and its related communities in the Brisbane, Logan, and Gold Coast regions, as well as nationally and internationally. The university's commitment to the pursuit of excellence in teaching, research, and community service is embedded in its forward-looking approach that combines the best of university traditions and values with innovation. The hallmark of Griffith's activities is the bringing together of disciplines in the development of courses and research activities that meet the changing needs of society. Its activities are informed by the university's close links with business and the community. Griffith is widely recognized for its commitment to equity and access and to community service. As an active member of the Gold Coast community, Griffith is concerned that residents of this region
do not enjoy the same level of access to higher education as some other parts of Australia. Griffith has initiated a new campaign to lobby the Commonwealth Government to increase by 3,000 the number of publicly funded student places allocated to the Gold Coast region. If successful, this will bring the number of student places allocated to this region up to the national average. This campaign has the strong support of prominent local business and community leaders. Griffith University has an international approach to education and one of the most extensive networks of international linkages in Australia. The university's international student population is the largest in Queensland. Griffith also seeks to inculcate an international outlook in its Australian students, who it encourages to study overseas. In 1999, 80 Griffith students attended institutions overseas under the university's scholarship and exchange programs, and a further 70 students will avail themselves of these opportunities this year. Now that your studies are completed, you are entering a new and exciting phase. You're joining an elite group. Approximately only 12% of the Australian population aged 15 to 64 possess tertiary education qualifications. Consequently, you should enjoy better employment prospects and higher salary levels than less well-qualified sections of our community. However, the labor market you're entering is characterized by rising levels of uncertainty and turbulence, and growing competition for jobs. Governments and businesses are under intensifying pressures to become internationally competitive. Consequently, employers now show a preference for applicants who, in addition to technical skills and knowledge, display abilities to learn, to discover, and to discard obsolete knowledge, and to change direction. They also show a preference for personnel who have the capacities to work in different cultural environments and to be team players. As Griffith graduates, you have already acquired and developed these characteristics during your studies. I trust they will hold you in good stead as you pursue your professional and personal ambitions. As Griffith graduates, you join an impressive company of people who have gone before and who have already achieved success and acclaim in Australia and overseas. As our new graduates, I am sure you will make an equal contribution. You've completed another important step in what will be a lifetime learning experience. You've demonstrated a command of the knowledge and skills necessary for your chosen field of endeavor, as well as a willingness to persist with the level of discipline needed for high achievement in any field. As we continue this afternoon's proceedings, I express warm congratulations to each of you and extend to you our best wishes for your lives ahead. I now call on the deans, who will present the graduates from their respective faculties, who are to receive their awards at this ceremony.
Chancellor, Professor David Moss, Dean of the Faculty of Arts.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Arts who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Arts, Belinda Blacklock. Lynn Farley. Alison Gray. Susie Hall. Roma Manning. David Ubeda. Rebecca Wild. Sang Chen Wu. Bachelor of Arts with First Class Honours, Andrea Hardy. Bachelor of Arts in Creative Arts, Nadine Clark. Hilde Nilsson. Emma Warner. Bachelor of Arts in Japanese, Edward Batley. Aaron Laney. Lana McCone. Bachelor of Communication, Brendan Collins. Katie Crosby. Sean Hammond. Michelle Harris. Elizabeth Marcus. Renee Schwab. Marcus Tuhig. Cynthia Vinluan. Master of Arts, Yi Che Chang. Kai Chen Cheng. Sandy Chang. Linda Jaja. Jeffrey Fitzgibbon. Jerry Handoko. Daka Hanyurapong. Solomon Ho. Phoebe Shie. Ian Lee. Amity Lin. Xin Yi Lin. Josh Nicholas. Kapilakan Paizet. Monica Susantio. Makio Yubukata. Linda Zhang. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Arts.
Chancellor, Professor John Dewar, Acting Dean of the Faculty of Commerce and Management.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Commerce and Administration who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, John Barstad. Damien Crow. Michelle Weathered. John Ray. Bachelor of Business, Ahmed Abdi. Helen Aitzi. Randy Ankerwald. Melanie Bowles. Jusim Cha. Adelaide Chang. Bernadette Corcoran. Tricia Dethridge. Christy English. Leanne Fabila. Sam Fung. Glenn Giggins. Jason Gooch. Maximiliano Gonzalez Mendoza. Amy Greensill. Luke Hancock. Brad Hawkins. Emma Healy. Hilda Hope. Magne Hovland. Jonathan Hunter. Mandy Hinder. Karen Johnson. Angela Key. Michelle Lawrence. Kirsten Lee. Mick Sen Lee. Suzanne Lee Lovick. Pascal Lelong. Cynthia Ma. Matt McCarthy. Simon McCormack. Ellen McDermott. Kylie McDowell. Kelly Musgrave. Daryl Nielsen. Bell Ng. Carmel Nicholas. Belinda Norville. Mike Payu. Danny Pizarev. Tyson Quigg. Rebecca Robb. Aaron Robin. Malcolm Sanders. Coralie Schott. Mohammed Shahid. Ersten Sirebag. Chelsea Stoughton. Karen Sumpton. Ashley Van Heerden. Tammy Venter. Sylvia Vinchenk. Lisa Weir. Melissa Williams. Bachelor of Business in Restaurant and Catering Management, Yumi Ahn. Bachelor of Business in Retail Management, Kim White. Nadine Willey. Bachelor of Business and Bachelor of Arts in Japanese, Lee Ann Nichols. Bachelor of Business in Human Resource Management and Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, Gina Coetzee. Amanda Flynn. Bachelor of Commerce, Craig Pearson. Bachelor of Hotel Management, Makila Blennerhassett. Katrina Cho. Hee Suk Chun. Ranuka Koswati. Mark Dimu. Chung Chi Huang. Zen Jia. Jenny Kang. Eddie Lam Shin Chung. Cecilia Lazaru. Catherine Lee. Sarah Mills. Suzanne Pouzaris. Setiawan Siemon. Shivi Singh. Marisa Vun. Bachelor of Hotel Management and Bachelor of Arts in Japanese, Jason Spegona. Bachelor of Hotel Management and Bachelor of Business, Leia Dugu. Bachelor of International Finance, Juanita Berndt. Shelley Pera Kelly. Bachelor of Psychology with First Class Honours, Mary Rogers. Bachelor of Psychology with Second Class Honours Division A, Sharon Monahan. Master of Clinical Psychology, Tracy Waters. Master of Professional Accounting, Stephen Ching. Joseph Melnick. Nigel Plummer. Master of Tourism with Honours, Sang Hee Cho. Master of Tourism Management, Rosemary Tendra. Xiao Xiang. Chancellor, I present two graduates from the Faculty of International Business and Politics who have been granted the Bachelor of International Business, Chan Fu Lin. Marcio Oliveira da Silveira. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates.
Chancellor Professor Marilyn McMenamin, Dean of the Faculty of Education.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Education who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Education, Kylie Edwards. Stuart McKenzie. Jacqueline McDonald. Bachelor of Education with Second Class Honours Division A, Kylie Free. Graduate Certificate in Education Studies, Lynn Gibson. Sherilyn King. Paula Reville. Simone Sebon. Graduate Certificate in the Teaching of English as a Second Language, Judy Rushbrook. Master of Education, Robert Baker. Master of Education Studies, Gillian Kavanagh. Gail Virgo. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Education.
Chancellor, Professor Barry Harrison, Dean of the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering, Marcus Cousins. Stephen Doon. David Dubois. Derek Grant. Alex Lynn. And Stephen Thackwell. Bachelor of Engineering with Second Class Honours, Division B in Civil Engineering, Mitchell Bray. Bachelor of Information Technology, Nick McKeon. Andrew Stewart. Bachelor of Multimedia, Robert Overar. Stan Polotsky. Todd Reed. Matthew Seaman. Master of Information Technology, Satya Ahuja. Arvin Al. Sarabhajit Bahal. Haranda Boozer. Victor Chen. Agarash Dushi. Visual Guard. Vinette Goyle. Chen Hu. Paradip Ivan. Nagash Jayanti. Narsen Kandu. Julia Lee. Ready Melody. Nicodemus. Dinesh Patel. David J. Rana. Jasmine Reslevic. Gorgai Seon. Vikash Sharma. Nandi Sood. Sanjay Verma. Sri Navamas Yellow. Rong Zhang. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of the graduates from the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology.
Chancellor, Professor William Hogarth, Dean of the Faculty of Environmental Sciences.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Environmental Sciences who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Environmental Science, Tom Jenick. Tennille Mooney. Amberine Smith. Bachelor of Science, Thomas Gardner. Russell Halley. David Lopez. Brandon Page. Bachelor of Science with Second Class Honours, Division A, Stephanie Richardson. Bachelor of Science in Ecotourism, Sasha Goulding. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Environmental Sciences.
Chancellor, Professor Roger Willis, Dean of the Faculty of Health Sciences.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Health Sciences who have been granted the following awards. The Bachelor of Biomedical Science, Georgia Brett. Annalyn Caranto Evans. Linda Ferreira. Helen Nyman. The Bachelor of Exercise Science, Louisa Webb. David White. Bachelor of Exercise Science and Bachelor of Education, Carly Brown. Eleanor Boise. The Bachelor of Health Science, Renee Arendt. Kirsty Holgren. Rebecca Saul. Bachelor of Health Science with First Class Honours, Amanda Flood. Bachelor of Science in Environmental Health, Mark Hughes. Melissa Hunt. Natasha Nathan. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Health Sciences.
Chancellor, Professor John Dewar, Dean of the Faculty of Law.
Chancellor, I present a graduate from the Faculty of Law who has been granted the following award. Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours and Bachelor of Business, Letitia Marshall. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Law.
Chancellor, Professor Deborah Creedy, Dean of the Faculty of Nursing and Health.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Nursing and Health who have been granted the following awards. Bachelor of Nursing, Carolyn Macon. Diane Pace. Pam Palmer. Radha Raghu. Leah Ticehurst. Lorraine Woolcott. Annette Wood. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Nursing and Health.
Chancellor, Professor Greg Bamber, Director of the Graduate School of Management.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Graduate School of Management who've been granted the following awards. The Master of Business Administration, the MBA. Leonie Fowler-Smith. Paul Gist. Larry Lee. Sue Purdy. Gary Willis. The MBA with distinction, George Dunn. The MBA International, Maya Arvina. Yifan Chen. Manpreet Chatwell. Jonathan Huang. Jean Mark Lee Kam Tin. Karina Lowe. Lily Ma. Julia Markinkovich. Anupriya Negi. Iku Oguri. Grace Rahado. Prudence Roper. Pavlo Taranenko. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Graduate School of Management.
Ladies and gentlemen, there will now be a brief musical interlude performed by Amy Cutter and Paul Hankinson, students of the Queensland Conservatorium, Griffith University.
Thank you.
Chancellor, Professor Bill Lovegrove, Deputy Vice Chancellor, will now present candidates for the Award of University Medal. This will be followed by the presentation of candidates for the Award of Doctor of Philosophy.
Chancellor, the University Medal may be awarded in recognition of academic excellence to a graduate who has completed the requirements for both a bachelor's degree of the university and a degree with first class honours. Chancellor, I am pleased to present a graduate who has been granted the 2000 University Medal from the Faculty of Law, Letitia Marshall.
Professor Dennis Lincoln, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Research, will now present candidates for the Award of Doctor of Philosophy.
Chancellor, today the University is proud to honour graduates who have satisfied the rigorous criteria for the award of the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, taken in the Faculty of Commerce and Management. Dr. Fredline examined the ways in which local residents reacted to the staging of major sporting events within their communities. Chancellor, I present Dr. Elizabeth Fredline. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, taken in the Faculty of Education. Dr. Sinclair examined how social justice in education initiatives create inequalities. Chancellor, I present Dr. Mark Richard Sinclair. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, taken in the Faculty of Engineering and Information Technology. Dr. Thornton researched constraint weighting as a search technique and evaluated its usefulness. Chancellor, I present Dr. John Richard Thornton. Chancellor, the following graduate has been granted the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, taken in the Faculty of Health Sciences. Dr. Woods investigated the regulation and molecular analysis of particular enzymes and the threat they pose to the dairy industry. Chancellor, I present Dr. Ricky Graham Woods. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of Doctor of Philosophy graduates.
With the authority of the Council, I shall now confer the degree of the Doctor of the University, and I call upon Vice Chancellor Professor Roy Webb to read the citation.
Chancellor, the Council of the University has resolved to award the degree of Doctor of the University to Mr. James Strong. James Alexander Strong was born in 1944 in Lismore, New South Wales. His early education saw him study at the Royal Military College in Duntroon, and he later passed the Barrister's Admission Board course at the Law Extension Committee at the University of Sydney. As well as practising as a barrister and solicitor in three Australian states, James Strong has proved himself one of the leading forces in the corporate world of marketing and management over the last 20 years. After working for 6 years as an industrial officer for the Sugar Producers Association of Brisbane, he entered the mining industry when he joined Namalco Proprietary Limited in 1970. Over a 13-year period, he occupied several key positions in this organisation, including Chief Industrial Officer, Personnel and Legal Manager, and Administration Manager for the Northern Territory and Sydney. His long association with Namalco Proprietary Limited culminated with his appointment as Site Manager of the Gove Project, which was responsible for bauxite mining and alumina refining operations in the Northern Territory. His considerable knowledge of the mining industry was recognised in 1983 with his appointment as Executive Director of the Australian Industry Mining Council in Canberra. In the next decade, James Strong's dynamic management skills contributed to the successful development of a number of important industries. As Chief Executive Officer of Australian Airlines from 1986 to 1989, he played a significant role in the transformation of the former TAA from a government airline to a fierce competitor that displaced Ansett as the country's premier domestic carrier, making Australian Airlines the market leader in the field. Following his appointment as National Managing Partner, Chief Executive and Chairman of the law firm Coors Chambers and Westgarth in 1989, Mr. Strong was instrumental in negotiating several major mergers to create one of Australia's largest law corporations. Early in the 1990s, he moved to New Zealand to undertake the role of Chief Executive of the DB Group, a public company involved in breweries, wineries, spirit distilling, liquor retailing and hotels throughout New Zealand and Australia. In October 1993, James Strong returned to the aviation industry, this time as Chief Executive and Managing Director of Qantas Airways Limited. In 1995, he led the float of Qantas, which took the government carrier to further success in the highly competitive airline business. He has also served as director of numerous Qantas Group companies. In a period of unprecedented change in the airline industry with the emergence of new carriers and the formation of strong international alliances, Qantas has come through in a strong and stable position, recording years of continuous growth. While many airlines are reporting only mediocre results in a highly competitive industry, James Strong has led Qantas to new highs. He has restructured the company to boost efficiency and productivity while maintaining a strong focus on customer service and satisfaction. Qantas presents an extraordinary safety record to travellers, and James Strong has ensured that the airline's amenities have maintained a very high standard against other competitors. Under his leadership, Qantas has committed millions of dollars in revamping the fleet and terminal facilities to ensure the organisation's worldwide success. As a tribute to his long and distinguished career in the aviation industry, he was elected as Chairman of the Board of Governors of the International Air Transport Association in 1999. The depth and diversity of James Strong's management skills have been recognised by many prestigious awards over the last 10 years. These include the Sir Charles Medal for significant contributions to marketing in Australia in 1991, the Louis Vuitton Channel 9 Award for the successful public float of Qantas in 1995, the BRW Business Management Award for the transformation of Australian Airlines in 1996, and the Aviation Week and Space Technology Laureate Award in the United States for achievement in international commercial aviation in 1998. It is fitting that Griffith University should honour James Strong in recognition of his outstanding contributions the corporate community. Chancellor, it is with great pleasure that I present to you James Strong for admission to the degree of Doctor of the University.
On behalf of the Chancellor, I'd now like to call upon Mr. Strong, Doctor of the University, to deliver the occasional address.
His Excellency the Governor, the Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, leaders of the academic staff of the University, graduates, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to make a few brief personal remarks today following this very prestigious award, which I regard as a great personal honour. I'd also like to acknowledge the presence here of the Governor. The Governor and I, you may have noticed, I was born in Lismore. The Governor was born in Lismore also, and we both went to Lismore High School. We both went to Duntroon Military College at about the same time. The Governor, of course, went on to a distinguished military career, whereas I didn't. I got sidetracked along the way. And in fact, when I left Duntroon, it was my intention to become a lecturer in English literature. So you can see I really did get lost along the way. But it is a great personal honour for me to have the Governor attend today, and I'd like to acknowledge that, and also his wife, Mrs. Barbara Arneson. I don't intend to make a long, boring business speech today because today belongs to the people who have graduated here. I'd like to congratulate everyone who has been given a degree or an advanced degree today. I think it is important in our lives that when we reach a certain standard by hard work and by persistence, that we do pause and acknowledge that achievement. It's a time of personal satisfaction, and I think it's also a time for relatives and friends to share in that satisfaction. And I think the pride that comes with it is very important at a personal level. It's a great honour for me to have this degree conferred upon me. I regard Griffith University as a wonderful example of a modern university, which has taken all the traditions and the structure of university learning over many years and has adapted it in a way so that it is very much attuned to the modern world in terms of the scope of subjects that it covers, the very way in which it operates off more than one location, and of course the outstanding way in which it is attracting people from overseas to come here and get degrees and go back and to use the knowledge that they've gained in this country. So to the Chancellor and the Vice-Chancellor and all of the distinguished staff, my congratulations on the success of the university, which gives me even greater satisfaction in terms of having this honorary doctorate awarded to me. I'd like not to talk today about some of the big contemporary issues which are running. We've all seen in the last week a world of exciting developments one way or the other with the World Economic Forum, which was exciting in some ways that a lot of people probably regret, but very significant in terms of some of the developments in the world today. All of the trends of globalisation in the industry in which I'm now involved. These things, whilst they're very interesting, they're not the subject for today, and they're matters which become dated very quickly, as I'm sure everyone here is aware. I was recently amused to be sitting watching a film on television, which was in French, which meant that my wife didn't have to read the subtitles as I did. And in it, immediately, in the middle of this film, suddenly there was an aphorism which stuck in my mind. It said, "Entomologists come and go, the frogs stay the same," which is a good statement about many things in our society and some of the short-term turbulences that we see. I was also very struck this week. My wife and I went to see a Jacobean play by John Webster called The White Devil. And for those of you who know Jacobean theatre, it's rather like Shakespeare, only a little more dramatic. And it deals with subjects such as jealousy, greed, lust, betrayal. And we were sitting next to Bob Carr, the Premier of New South Wales, and he said it just reminded him of his work. I didn't have the heart to tell him that it just reminds me of my work as well. I'd just like to take this occasion to make a few personal remarks. I think for anyone at my age, it is always fascinating to look back over your life, not in the sense of second-guessing things, but just being able to see by retrospectivity, by that perspective of looking backwards, the key phases in your life and what are pivotal decisions and events, whether you recognise them at the time or not. And I think for many of us, we don't always recognise pivotal events. I think at some stage, all of us are also struck by the thought, if I only knew then what I know now. But of course, experience is one of life's great teachers. And of course, wisdom, in many ways, is just the basis of experience interpreted in an intelligent way. I think for all of us, and I hope these comments are relevant to the people graduating here today, trying to lead a fulfilling life in a personal sense and in a community sense is just one perpetual balancing act. It's a question of trying to balance your own attitudes so that, for instance, there's sufficient confidence to give you personal momentum and to have enough belief to persevere and believe that you can have an impact on events around you. But on the other hand, not having so much confidence that it gets into arrogance, a very poor quality in people. Having a sense of competitiveness, but not so strong that it leads to vindictiveness or over-aggressive approaches in dealing with people, and so on. I could go through a whole list of these, none of which would be new to the people here today. But I think when any one of us looks back over a period in our lives, and I only mention this because of the honour I feel in this recognition here today, that we all come back to the fact that the simple values, such as common sense, an ability to communicate with other people, an ability to take a real interest and try to see other people's perspective, an ability to interact with other people, these are the things that are really very important, no matter whether you're in business, academic life, or in community service. And to me, the things that have always given me the greatest satisfaction in anything that I've done has been where, working with other people, it has been possible to bring about a real change in people's attitude. And that certainly has been the case in some of the change programs that I've been involved in. The Chancellor and other members of staff and I were having a brief chat before coming out here today and commenting, of course, it's simple common sense that none of us likes change if it threatens us. And certainly in a lot of businesses today, there is a lot of change. It's inevitable. It's being rolled forward whether we like it or not. And if you're able, by spending a lot of time talking to people and trying to explain what's driving those forces, and instead of just trying to roll over the top of people, actually convince them that if they behave in a way that gives them credit for intelligence and being able to take part in changing circumstances to respond, then indeed the outcome for them, rather than being negative, can be very, very positive. And certainly that's one of the things which I think, in terms of getting the greatest self-satisfaction from work, can be very rewarding. As the Vice-Chancellor mentioned, I've been involved with Qantas over the last 7 years, and in that organisation, what we've tried to do is to take people who'd been treated as though they had no intelligence to contribute to the future direction of the organisation, and whilst at the same time forcing through dramatic change, We've let them take ownership and responsibility for the results. And the way in which that has allowed them to develop personally and to show great pride in doing things which they did not imagine that they would have ever been given the authority to do before is transforming the whole organisation. And I think that's terribly important for people, and no matter which field, artistic endeavour or community service, academia or whatever, I think for all of us it still comes back to your ability to deal with people, and certainly in terms of getting a great deal of satisfaction and real enjoyment from a career, I still think that is the critical issue. I think it's also important never to forget, never to lose sight of the fact that what you do as a career, as a vocation, is one of the greatest opportunities you'll have to get satisfaction, a sense of achievement, and to take great personal pride in the role that you play. And if that is seen, and that is the way in which you approach your career right throughout your life, then I think as long as there is balance in the rest of your life, it will certainly be a major contributor to having a feeling of achievement at a personal level, which is one of the most positive forces that we can all unlock in ourselves, and if we're really interested in other people as well. So I hope that everyone here who's going on to a career working closely with people does feel that satisfaction of being part of transforming the atmosphere through communication, taking personal interest, and being very persistent in trying to get people to understand so that they will turn and work positively with whatever is necessary to be done in the field of endeavour in which you're engaged. Now, Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, can I conclude by saying again what a great honour it is for me to receive this doctorate today. It means a great deal to me, and I thank you and the members of the university staff, and again to the graduates to whom today belongs. I hope you have a very satisfying career, and I hope you get a lot of enjoyment in going through that career. Thank you very much.
Excellency, Chancellor, if I may call him such, Dr. Strong. It's a great pleasure now on behalf of everyone here for me to offer a vote of thanks to James Strong, first of all for accepting the honour which we have bestowed on him and about which he's been very kind, and also of course for his address to us and particularly to our graduates this afternoon. This is a very historic occasion for Griffith. We have with us our new Chancellor, who's described herself as a Gold Coaster. We have our former Chancellor in the audience, the Honourable John McCrossan and Marjorie. We have our current Governor. We have our former Governor. And if you would like to work out how four makes three, then you can call that afterwards. Griffith has an important connection with aviation, as may not be aware to everyone here today, but we have a very influential school of aviation, copied by many universities around the country and involved in training pilots and preparing people for management in aviation. And this is an additional reason why it's so important today that we have recognised this particular prominent Australian career through this honorary doctorate. Dr. Strong, I have to tell you that our current contractors with ANSET, and it has been for a while now, we've probably kept ANSET afloat while you've been trying to compete with out of business, but I think the contract is up for grabs soon, and no doubt a bid will be received from Qantas. Dr. Strong has congratulated our university. I'm delighted on behalf of everyone here to thank him for his congratulations on the university's progress and its innovatory path. Through his later remarks, he has stressed a number of important qualities. You didn't hear about high tech, you didn't hear about aeroplanes very much, or the internet. You heard about perseverance, common sense, working with people, perseverance, dealing with people, and all these things are the things that, looking back on his life, Dr. Strong thinks have contributed to the huge contribution he has made to Australian industry and management. Well, there is much food for thought there. Ladies and gentlemen, would you join with me again in thanking Dr. Strong for his address? And may I offer my congratulations to all our graduates on their success and to wish them wonderful careers and to ask them to join the Alumni Association and stay with us. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ceremony is now concluded. When the music begins, please rise and remain standing as the dais and staff procession along with the graduates retire.